Hey guys, Darth Glork here, back with part 6, I think, of our Bounty Hunter playthrough on Star Wars The Old Republic. So, last time we got very, very far. We participated in a Mandalorian death game. And we helped, what's his name, Torian, reclaim his clan's honor and shoot his dad in the face. Because I'm a great person like that. And, yeah, so he was super stoked. We are on our way to romancing him. And now we also won the Great Hunt. That's something else that we did. I don't think it was last episode, but we won the Great Hunt. And now we are participating in the super special Blacklist. So I did level up a wee bit, and I got us to almost level 40, so that's pretty sweet. And happy to be moving on. Last thing I wanted to say before we got into this is I wanted to say thank you guys so much for the participation and the views on my Bounty Hunter playthrough so far. I've been looking at it, and for me, I've been getting crazy views on this whole playthrough so far. So thank you all so much for participating and watching, and hopefully you guys are enjoying the content just like I'm enjoying playing it. So, I was on Tatooine leveling up. Now we are moving on to Hoth. So let's go. I'm ready. Alright, here we are on the icy world of Hoth. It's like home sweet home. I actually really like Hoth because it's all snow covered, and I like snow places in games.
I'm here to interrogate your prisoner.
This can't be authentic. Wait here. I mean it. You will please excuse my manners before. The prisoner is right this way. Little rat has been nothing but trouble.
What do you mean?
It slipped out of its cell 6 times since the patrols brought it in. Don't ask me how. Never makes a run for it, though. Just noses around and starts taking things apart. It's driving me crazy.
Space armor, good color. You paint, many lights, and flybox. Zoom, yes, it has flamethrower too.
Think all the white maw will be this threatening?
Good luck understanding it. Show yourself out when you're finished.
He's so cute. This nice blaster, you have big hands. Now you hold this.
Give it back, and I'll show you.
Okay, here you go. Ah, that was easy.
Tell me what you know about Renegade Voss, the Trandoshan.
Boss Voss? Boss Voss kinda crazy. Always go find Harm out in White Sand with no cold clothes. One time, drag himself back to camp, feet like ice, arm shoot off, fistful of wampa pelts and teeth. Boss Voss dragged Blizz along on hunt in cold white sand. Sick crew on Blitz like pack of womp rats. Can't go back now.
Where's the last place you saw them?
Blizz has been here a little while now. Make a good guess, though. Try hunting camp Boss Voss drag Blizz to down in Big Ice Cave. It not far. Maybe he's still there? Oh, he said something else at the end of that. I didn't realize it. The text had switched, so I wasn't reading it. My bad. Anyway, he's so adorable. I don't know about you, but like, Jawas are so cute. Especially him, because he's all wrapped up in these cold, in his like, winter gear. I've never seen a Jawa on a snow planet. Still, he's so adorable. Alright. Guess I will go ahead and head to our first objective, and I will see you guys there. Alrighty, here we are at our objective. We ran into some rando towels, but 'twas no big deal. On the way here, I mean. They had nothing on us, man. So I don't know if I showed this, because my memory's very foggy on what we did last time. But, in case you haven't seen it, I did dye Torian's armor. So obviously he's wearing Mandalore the Preserver's armor. And that, I'm pretty sure you guys did know. But I don't know if you guys saw it dyed. Well, it is dyed. So dye the same color as mine with the same kind of dye. So now we're all matching. Anyway. So I don't know if you guys saw that or not, but now you have. So we're covered either way. Ah, it looks like there is wampas in this cave. So I also looked into it. So I looked into it, and So Torian has to be a melee character. You cannot give him a rifle, because I did look. So unfortunately, he has to be a melee character. So I have him on tank because, you know, it makes more sense than him healing me from up there, which doesn't make sense. So, I've been using him as a tank for the heroics, and it seems to go pretty well. Pretty much. Die, Wampa. There we go. Alright. Oh, is my little lizard with us? Yes, he is. Good. Just wanted to make sure, man. He's like the mascot. He has to be with me. Otherwise, my ability to fight is diminished. Stupid little Wampa thought he could come attack me. I don't think so. Man, I am a little sad, though. The heroics on Hoth are tough. And level-wise, I think I'm going to need to do them. Unfortunately. So, I think we'll do the story on this planet. That'll get us to maybe almost level 41. Maybe a little over, a little under, something like that. And that's the highest level for this planet. I guess then maybe depending on what planet is next, maybe we will try doing that. And then off-camera, I will come back after we're done recording and then hit all the heroics for this planet. Is possibly what might happen. At a guess. So, I was thinking about, while we're just doing this busy work, I was thinking about what I wanted, like, other really good games we could play on my channel. I think doing Oblivion, like, from the Elder Scrolls series, I think doing Oblivion would be fun. Just because I have only played a few, maybe like an hour or whatever, into Oblivion, and so it would be mostly blind. If we did it, because odds are I won't play it before we do it on my channel, odds are. But anyway, I think that'd be fun. I think that'd be a good one. I also want to look into the Borderlands series. I own Borderlands 1 for 360, but I have only played like 20 minutes into it, so. Aha! You! Now, offer Beast a Scorekeeper. Show you are worthy hunter worthy of her notice. Not like that. Blech. There, this is how you give praise to Scorekeeper, with blood on your teeth. I hear you, who lurks in darkness while we feast. Carrion eaters are unwelcome here. Do not intrude on this hunt.
You're in no position to make demands. Trust me.
Bounty Hunter comes for my blood. She shall leave disappointed. I have torn eyes from Wookiee chieftains with bear claws alone. Feasted on crate dragon flesh, crushed armadas. I do not debase my Jagannath by swatting yapping dogs.
You wouldn't be the first unstoppable target I've taken down.
You need more than tough talk to impress Scorekeeper. You are nothing to me, soft thing hiding in hard shell, unknown, untested, unworthy. Bigger prey awaits me. This manhunter has spirit. Boost your young blood scores nicely. I leave her to you. Paint your glares in her blood. Oh, please. I think I'm scared of these little peasants. Oops. I don't know why I didn't expect them to move. There you go. Get closer. A little closer. Perfect. Intercepted. Hey. Stop it. I can cut you. Neener, neener, neener. All right. Yeah, I'm mature. Thank you for pointing that out. Alright, let me just top off me health. Give me a minute. Okay. Help! Boss, help! Come back! She's too tough!
I heard Boss was a holy terror. Why'd he leave you to do the dirty work?
Captain think we weak. Make him look bad. Take us on hunt to show how we be strong. We hunt small prey. He hunt big. You came and Captain say you small, so we fight. But you not small. I just want to go back to mop decks.
Fry piggy.
Pew.
Boss didn't think much of us.
Guess not.
Come on. We're paying Blizz another visit.
Yeah, back to the cute little Jawa. So, while we are teleporting back there, something else that I am working on. So on the side, just for fun, I am pushing my level 70 Inquisitor through the DLC. And I am in Knights of the Fallen Empire right now. And so my whole thing is I'm doing it for two reasons. One is I am pushing through because I want to see how much of the DLC I have available to use to like play through. So then, depending on how much I have there, I can know if I can do it on my channel. Because my idea here is, and I think this would be fun, is on my channel is, obviously on the side, I am pushing through the DLC. Once I know how far I can go, then I can decide whether or not we will ever hit the DLC on my channel. So I think what we would do is we would choose like a good class that I enjoyed playing on the channel, and then I would push that class through the DLC. I don't think I would push all 8 classes through the DLC if we did that on my channel. I think I would pick probably one, maybe one on each side, like one good and one bad, and maybe. But at least once through, all the way through, just depending on how much I have, because if I don't have enough to tell the complete story, then I won't start it. But if I do, then maybe we'll think about it. So we will have to see what happens with that. But if we did that, that would be at the very end after we do our last class story. So if that we decide to do that, that is when we will do it. And by then, I will have done the DLC for my Inquisitor. The other reason is because I have access to an HK companion in my mailbox, and it tells you how to do it and stuff. And so I am pushing to get there with my character, my Inquisitor, to see if I can unlock that companion to carry around. So that is the plan, man. All right, Blizz, what's up, man?
Boss took off, let his cronies do the dying. Said I wasn't worthy.
No fight. Jagga this, Jagga that. All Voss talk about. Blizz not understand. Blizz got it. Boss Voss think you are not worthy worth Jagga Jagga points. Waste of time. Blizz think if new friend beat up other big captains, Boss Voss think new friend worth big Jagga. He come to you.
Slow down. What do you mean by Jagga points?
Jagannath.
It means Jagannath points.
Yeah, exactly.
Is a religion to Trandoshans. Their goddess gives them Jagannath for successful hunts. It's serious business to them. The Trandoshan score determines his place in the afterlife.
Boss Voss not think much of others, only other big captains in White Ma. Blizz guess they have good scores. Closest big captain, he creepy three-eyed droid man, Ayor V9. Big boss of hot tunnel power plant not far from here.
Know anything to help me deal with Ayor?
He not like people much, only droid. He has laser brain. Talk to droid friends all the time, have many, many droid friends. Droid man have other parts inside too, make him tough. But big thing be deflector shield, come off starfighter, super strong. New friend be okay though, Blizz know how to take things apart, even three-eyed droid man.
What have you got in mind, Blizz?
Big Blizz recalibrate blaster, make output super ion blast, zap big sparks, droid man something or other. Big, oh my gosh, it's so hard to read. Blizz old salvage crew bring parts for work on hot tunnel. Blizz old boss someone tell slam get 3-phase field frequency tuner from Blizz stash. Also need heat resistor from plant. Holy crap.
Slam striever, field tuner, heat resistor. Got it.
Need tuner to short out the shield, point, push big red button, droid man shield, reboot, simple. Tell new friend slam, Blizz okay, beat up creepy, three eye good. Oh my gosh, so hard to read. When he's all going on and on and on, and I'm like, and then you have to read it in his weird, like, the weird way that he speaks because he's a little Jawa. So I'm like choking on it. It's so much easier to talk to people who speak basic because then I can just mute my mic and just watch. So much easier. Anyway, I will head to our next objective and I'll see you guys there. Alrighty, here we are. Took a while to get here, but we got here. Because you have to go through all of this and there's a lot of guys on the way here. And that's not even counting what's outside of this little facility. So, you know, it takes a while. You, please tell me you speak basic.
Whoa, buddy, we're just salvagers. Don't want no trouble. They ain't getting paid to catch blaster fire.
Who's calling the shots here?
I'm looking for Slam Streever. Blizz sent me.
Blizz? You're pulling my leg. Really? I'm glad to hear the little guy's okay. Never sat right with me, what Voss done to him.
Blizz said you could help me find some equipment.
I'm just an old part picker. But I reckon if Blizz sent you to me, he knew I could do you some sort of good. I'll do whatever I can to help. What did Blizz send you for?
I need a couple of your heat resistors and a three-phase field frequency tuner from Blizz's stash.
Well, heat resistor's no problem. That phase tuner could be another story. Foreman divvied up most of Blizz's stuff between the salvage crews, but I'll have a look. But you're in luck. Everything you asked for is here. What's left of Blizz's stuff, too. I appreciate it if you could get that back to him. And tell him I'm sorry, would you?
That much I can do.
Thanks. That means a lot to me. It's about time we pack it up. The foreman's gonna figure out we helped you. And he won't take kindly to that. We ain't much good in a scrap, and likely won't get far without someone who is.
Lend a hand?
Let's not waste any more time.
I'll cover the rear.
Come on, boys. We're getting out of here.
Groans internally. He's like, are we gonna lend a hand? I was like, fine. I tell you what, I think Torian's good nature is rubbing off on me. I used to be a pretty risque lady, you know. Pretty much killed everyone I laid eyes on. But who knows, maybe I'm turning over a new leaf. Not that I'm romancing Torian, you know what I mean? Trading in the hate for more honor. Die, you droid scum. Gonna be honest, I kind of expected that to be ready. I actually didn't mean to open the menu. Alright.
We ought to be able to make it from here. Thanks for sticking your neck out for us. We'd have never made it.
Show me your gratitude some other time. I've got a cyborg to kill.
Be careful. That fella's packed with more tech than a Nar Shaddaa chop shop. And has about as many screws loose. You take care of Blizz for me, yeah?
You're welcome, buddy. I did it for Blizz. He was too adorable not to help. And that guy's Blizz's friend, so I helped him. There you go. That's the simple of it. Like, Blizz, if you weren't so stinking adorable, I never would have done it. Pew! Oops, didn't mean to. I meant to hit the other one. I actually didn't mean to hit that one, but. Torian! Adrian! Hang on, we can do this. Thanks for showing up, Torian. Facing these morons by myself. Alright, well that was close. Way too close. Look, that's the reason why is because Torian was standing over there like an idiot while I ran in assuming he would be right behind me. And guess what? I was wrong, see? Alright, this time you go first. I'm not moving until I know you're going in first. And there's a bonus objective to kill the droids, so obviously we're gonna do that. Because the more I level up here, the less heroics I have to do. Hey, there's a bonus objective. Too easy. Alright. Some easy free experience. Aha, just the droid I was looking for. Actually, the not droid guy I was looking for. I was looking for him, but he's not a droid. Murderer! Murderer! My family! You're trying to take them from me.
I'm only here for you, Aeor.
No, they are safe with me. I won't let you hurt them anymore. You talking about the droids? Their minds are dark, but I can hang on to them, give them bodies again, return them from death. I will never find myself alone again.
Okay, freak show. Time to put you out of your misery.
That's so aggressive. You cannot take them from me? Just, okay, freak show. Alright, that was weird. As I hit this one and I hit it, but then she like did the unload, so I don't know what's up with that. Chewing that, nerd. Alright, let me just heal up and then we are headed back to the cute little Jawa. Oh, Blizz, I'm back. I killed the dude, I helped your friend, I'm an oddly good person suddenly. What happened to me?
Slam asked me to bring you this.
Gift from Slam, Blizz old stuff. Blizz, thank new friend and Slam. Ah, this all that left of Blizz's thing? Stupid Dreely. Blizz, get Dreely back someday.
Could be worse. You could have been left with nothing at all.
New friend, right. Blizz thankful for Slam and new friend getting things back with other tech. New friend need heat register to get next big captain, Gradic Ungin. His boss of white moss smelting, big plant set up around the river. Heat resistor not strong enough to protect from Rock River. Blizz work to boost output.
What's a Rock River?
It hot and glowy and runny. Oh, like when sand get under flame torch while welding. Rock River very hot, so Boss Gradic and other hornheads run smelting. Only ones that not need tech for heat and smoke. Most work done by prisoners though, cause Boss Gradic think they not much loss when tech fail.
What's so special about Gradic that the Trandoshan would care if I kill him?
Blizz hear rumor say Boss Gradic it was big Republic soldier in last war. After war, deserted, became raider to take. Crews say Republic send ships to stop Boss Gradic, but Hornhead man take fight to them and steal whole fleet. Boss Gradic was one to push Empire and Republic out of White Maw territory. That earned him place as big captain.
He's not gonna have an army when I find him.
Blizz sure new friend beat up Hornhead real good. Blizz finished now, output not great, and it not last forever, but this lasts until new friend find real thermal shield at smelting plant. Biz think. Better to hurry, not take chance. Blizz like new friend, Blizz not want new friend to get cooked. Thanks, man. Cute little droid guy. Not droid guy, I was thinking of the other droids earlier. Cute little Jawa dude. Little Jawa guy. There we go, that blends a lot better. I mean, it doesn't matter, obviously. We ain't wearing it. Alrighty, here we are. Now this time, getting into this whole crevice thing was way easier than you would believe. So, turns out, as this big old road, historically, I often run all the way over here and then go down this way. And because usually it's either here or here. Well, ours was right here. So as I was running past, I got to like here and I'm like, wait a minute, like, what does this path lead? So I turned around and went around. Turns out, it's a ramp and it goes right down to where you want. So, that's pretty funny. Okay, I ran the wrong way. Alright, we're good. Alright, lots of droids and rando people, which means nothing, of course.
Gotcha.
Ah, there's a bonus objective too. How convenient. Alright, well, I guess I will work my way through this, and I'll see you guys when we are closer to our actual objective.
Hey, hey! Aha! Over here, please! You gotta help us! They've got us chained to the equipment, and they cut off our thermal shields if we give them any trouble.
He's not exaggerating. Alien scum are working us to death. Help us.
What do I get out of this arrangement?
You, callous.
All right, sorry. Old habit. Right, turning over a new leaf, blah, blah, blah.
Hey,
I'm not here to rescue prisoners.
Maybe we can help you. A little trade.
Tell me where I can replace my heat gear, and I'll consider helping you.
I don't know that they store any. When one of us dies, they give that shield to the replacement.
You can take my thermal shield if you can free us. You probably need it more than I do.
Don't be an idiot, that's suicide!
It's the only chance we've got.
Take this heat resistor. I won't be needing it.
Thank you. I'll hold out as long as I can.
Don't worry. It's covered.
Who would have thought? I'm turning so soft. Alright. Where the heck am I going? Over here. Hopefully there's a couple of kills on the way. Oh, there is. What luck. Hey, there's our bonus objective. Here we go. Shut down the perimeter force field controls. Locate Gradic Ungen. I assume that's how you pronounce that. Yep. He is across the way. Apparently. Over here. You know, I don't even have to fight these guys anymore. There's no bonus objective, so now it's like, psh, who cares? There we go. Now it's nice and toasty down here. Goodbye, idiot. No, I'm kidding. He'll be back. That's certainly not enough to kill him. Because you just finish this quickly, Torian? We have other priorities, and these idiots aren't one of it. Oh, I gotta replace my mods. That gun is barely better than what I'm using.
That's quite a kit you're sporting, Bounty Hunter. Bet you spilled a lot of blood to get it. Now, whose pride did I wound so badly that they resorted to a hired gun? The Republic? The Empire? Both?
Hate to burst your bubble. But you're just the means to an end.
You really have no idea who I am, do you?
In a minute, it won't matter.
I was one of the Republic's finest, Merc. Best training, best equipment, best assignments. If they'd offered the best pension, I'd probably still be there. If you came here looking for an easy kill, you made a grave mistake.
Oh, please. I didn't make the mistake. You did! Yeah, you thought you were cool, huh? Sup, nerd?
Hope you like it hot, Jetna. I'm not dying alone.
Maybe, maybe not. But you are dying.
Haha. Chewing that, nerd. Alright, let's GTFO. We are on fire. Come on, Torian. I'm not dying in this stupid cave. I got a life to live. Bounties to claim. Up. Quickly. Eh. Hey. Rando Imperial. Ah, there we go. It's only moderate heat. I guess it's an improvement.
The heat resistor you gave Paul helped, but it was still too much for him. He passed out.
Don't worry, he'll make it, even if I have to drag him all the way.
Don't get captured again. I'm not handling any more rescues.
You're right. Thanks for your assistance.
I thought we were goners. Thank you.
This is like, hey, just because I helped you doesn't mean I'm soft, okay? I only did it because Torian wanted me to, and technically, I'm trying not to be a heartless, ruthless, like, mercenary, okay? We're trying our best. It's a rough transition, to say the least. Yes, I see the light! Huzzah, we're outside. New friend has been gone long time. Blizz want to check in.
Traffic was impossible out here.
Blizz wire into Blue Funny Alien Man Network, but it all fuzzy, so Blizz make a few adjustments. All better now. Now that mean hornhead man gone, Blizz bet Boss Voss think twice about new friend now. Only big captain left is big rival. There's no way Voss not fight if new friend beat up chief rival.
Who am I after now, Blizz?
Big one-eye man. Key to someone else. Boss Kren, big chief, tribe chief from Bice. Always drag, he survive more something. When big one-eye come join White Ma, he get into boasting match with Boss Voss. They get in big fight. Huge.
I only need to know his location, Blizz.
Boss, taskmaster for fixing big super dreadnought in Heart of Starship Graveyard. New friend, fight Kren, then take some comm codes and call Voss from Dreadnought. Big comm array there, super strong, reach Boss for sure, then Voss fight.
I'll chat with Voss as soon as I'm done with Kren.
We did it again, but holy crap, it's hard reading him, right? It's hard reading what he says, because it's like... I'm like choking on his words, because obviously it's not, they're not like normal complete sentences, you know what I mean? So it's like, I'm like scrambling to read fast enough. It's an uphill battle. Alrighty, here we are. We have finally made it. And Mr. Kita Kren, if that's his real name, he won't escape us. I'm a bounty hunter on a mission. Well, looks like he is behind that door, and we have to get it open. Which, you know, shouldn't be hard. Just find the blue glowing object. There you go. See? That was easy. Alright, Torian, next group here. Ah, there you are, you little crackhead. You have no idea how many guys I killed to get to you. The enemy is on the march. Why are those cannons still offline? I wondered when you'd come.
If you know who I am, you know why I'm here.
You intend for me to share fates with Greydak and Aeor V9. I should raise the alert and bring the entire ship down on your head. Even if you killed me, you would find no escape. Oh yeah? Capture and torture would be your fate. It would disappoint Renegade to learn you came to so far only to be robbed of glorious death.
I do hate to disappoint.
Good. Then we shall meet as warriors. My people have a ritual of communion we partake in before a blooding. Will you join me?
If you intend to put up a fight, Kren, let's get on with it.
Very well. It is your day to die. Join me in the blooding. The rest of you do not interfere. May the strong survive. Die, you fool. Wow, force lightning. Well, fired that too late. Yeah, do you like that, eh, scumbag? Alright, let me just heal up Torian here. And let's hit him with this. You're welcome. Okay. You are a tenacious one. I see now that you will be a great match for Renegade. It is likely that either you or our brother will die in the bloodshed to come. Now at least I will not be alone when fate chooses the victor.
Don't die just yet, Kren. I still need your comm codes.
I'm not as so far gone as you think. These wounds will fade in time. Let me speak. We share a kinship now, you and I. Two tribes joining in the aftermath of bloodshed, but the blooding is not yet complete. All the tribes spill blood. You must face our brother, and this, I fear, I will only trade one sibling for another.
You and me, we ain't gonna be real close.
There you go. Problem solved. Oh, jeez. Yipe. Alright. Torian's like, why? I'd be like, come on, man. We fought, he lost, he dies. That's how that works. Don't be a drama queen. I'm hunting Kren. What can I wait until I return?
Kren can't talk right now. I came here to put you away. Nothing's gonna keep me from doing that. Aeor, Gradic, and Kren couldn't stop me. I don't think you can either.
So, Manhunter has found sport after all. I look forward to hunting those men when time was right. It's shame to lose such worthy prey. It seems I must find a new quarry.
No more hunting, boss. This is a challenge, not a game.
This life is game, Manhunter. A hunter of such skill must possess great horde of Jaggernauts. Scorekeeper will favor me for kill such as this. Wait for me on observation deck. We will find room for battle there. I will look forward to gnawing your bones. Oh, please. Works for me. Oh, please. I assume... How the heck do I get there? Oh, okay. Go back the way we came, and then go across the other way. Tell you what, though. Just because I'm, like, mostly turning over a new leaf doesn't mean I'm suddenly soft, okay? People still gotta die. Not even Torian can stop me from doing that. Alright. I don't know why that guy was... like, warped over here. That's pretty weird. Punk. Mr. Like, freaking moonwalk from the ramp over here. It's like, who do you think you are, Michael Jackson? Stop it! Alright. Let's go, Torian. These little gnats are in the way. Yeah, 41. 41. Okay. All right. Let's go, Torian. Ah, the battleground. You are here. Good. Scorekeeper shall watch me eat beating heart from your chest. I don't think so. Put up good fight, Manhunter, and I see you find fitting place in afterlife for feeding my destiny.
What your destiny is gonna eat is my boot, lizard.
Haha. Yes, show Scorekeeper you fight with some spine before I offer it to her. Your death will serve greater purpose. None have ever or will ever reap more Jaggernauth than Renegade Voss. When death finally claims me, Scorekeeper shall know this and take me as her mate. We shall be gods of hunt.
Are you here to fight or preach?
Yes, we both crave blood. We fight. Your Jaggernauth is mine. I don't think so, nerd. Ah, he's behind me. Wrong one. I hit vent and I was trying to stop him. And I wasted that because I was panicking. Yeah, how do you like that, Mr. I will rip your heart from your chest? Idiot. Ah, you are stubborn for soft things. Stand still and die.
I'm gonna have to decline.
You will not accept fate. It is your place to die. Swings, and I just step back. I'm like, shut up. And stay down, you idiot. It's my destiny to rise to Godhead. I will not be stripped of my Jagannath by capture.
Screaming won't change anything. Let's go.
I don't think losing ever crossed his mind. Hard lesson.
Yeah, indeed.
He gambled with his life. He should have been prepared to lose. Time to turn boss over to the Chiss.
Yay! I'm assuming the warden is back at base. Yes, he is. Alrighty, here we are. Let's go ahead and turn him in. Be like, I did it. I beat him. Now I demand your respect. Demand it!
I've captured Renegade Voss. Get your boss on the line.
And I thought Trandos looked hideous out of carbonite. Sir, your bounty hunter has just delivered Renegade Voss into my custody.
You've renewed my faith in your profession, bounty hunter. I'll be wiring a substantial sum to an account of your choosing.
Send it to this account. It's been a pleasure.
Likewise. I'll know who to contact if I have need of a capable hunter.
He just breaks out again.
That concludes our business. If there is nothing else.
What are you going to do with your prisoner now?
When there is no longer any use for it, it will be executed for its crimes against the Ascendancy.
He's harmless. Just let him go.
The White Maw's in shambles. You don't need to keep Blizz locked up.
The alien was a member of an organization that has caused a lot of damage to Chiss sovereign territory.
Enough, Kel. The creature's crimes are hardly exceptional, and its worth is questionable. If you agree to a reduction of your pay, I'll release it to your custody.
If it weren't for his help, you wouldn't have Voss right now. That not enough?
A fair point. Kel, release the creature, and see that it is delivered to the bounty hunter's ship.
Yes, sir.
Again, a pleasure dealing with you. Consider yourself a guest of the Ascendancy while on Hoth.
Yay! Alright. I helped Blizz get out, because he's too adorable to leave behind, man. You can't let him suffer like that. He's too adorable to leave behind. Taurian loved it. Even Taurian thinks he's adorable. He's like, we have to help him, man. He's too cute. Alrighty, back on the ship. So, first of all, Taurian has something to say.
You remind me of someone. A friend of mine, Cordan Ordo. Great Alorad. Served with him and his clan on Eriadu. Told you about that, right?
Pretty sure you didn't.
Sent in to secure a weapons factory. Half the planet is factories. Like Coruscant, but dirtier. Pretty quiet, except for snipers and mines. Real trouble was waiting in the factory. Resistance fighters, geared with stealth generators, hiding among the workers.
How'd you flush them out?
Stealth fields don't fool thermal detonators. Cordan got most of the workers out. Got us undercover. Could have been worse. Good at thinking on his feet. Sort of like you.
Guess I could do worse.
Hey. War stories. Alright. Use our intercom. Intercom! Blizz like new friendship. Much better than Slam's old one. Blizz joined new friend's crew to thank new friend for getting Blizz out of the blue man cage.
Behave yourself and pull your weight, and you can stay.
Blizz be big help, you see.
There goes the peace and quiet.
Oh, hush, we're all glad to have you along, Blizz.
I'll second that.
Looks like the Chiss sent the payout. Wow, you think we'll rake in this much on all our jobs now?
This keeps up, we might just retire with all our parts intact.
Retire? Was just getting started.
It won't last nearly as long as you think.
Well, if we're done here, I'm gonna go take a nice long shower.
Take Blizz with you. I don't think he's familiar with the concept.
Someone's calling to congratulate you. I can't miss this.
Well, so much for hazing. We're the only ones looking foolish. An unprecedented success.
I'll admit it. You're good.
Now that you're up to your ears in credits, you'll need an excuse to spend them.
Let's hear your offer, Bloodworthy.
You just took down the two hardest targets on the Blacklist, back to back. If that isn't cause for celebration, I don't know what is. So, we're throwing you a party. We've procured a penthouse suite for the occasion. Best spot on the promenade, I'm told.
I like your style. Not enough women worth respecting in this business.
Still aren't.
What was that?
Nothing. Should we take them up on it?
There's nothing else on our plate right now.
The room's already booked on Nar Shaddaa. You can meet us there.
Perfect. Sounds good to me, man. We're gonna go to a party. But first, literally everyone wants to talk. Torian first. He's most important.
Mind if I ask you a personal question?
If I answer it, I get to ask you something personal.
Fair enough. Are you seeing anyone?
No, but I could be talked into it by the right guy.
Really? I'll have to remember that. Guess it's only fair I let you ask one too. Shoot.
Your turn to tell me. You seeing anyone?
Not yet. Thinking about it though. We should get moving. We can talk later.
Ooh, it's adorable double talk because we both know. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
SIS just throw their ciphers a party with clowns and a juggling bantha. Stupid datapad is impossible to decrypt, but not all is lost. Found a holo address for Coral, I think. I mean, it could be her. I sort of wanted you around when I called her.
I've got your back, Mako. Call her.
What's the worst that can happen, right? It's not her, or it is her, and she instantly hates me. Not a problem. Right, it's nothing to worry about. It's just a stupid call.
Hello?
Hi. Coral? It's Coral, right? I'm Mako.
Mother of... Mako? My little sister Mako? I can't believe it. I thought you were dead. How did you find me?
Wasn't exactly easy. I ran into an SIS guy looking for you.
Isaac? The SIS agent? Was his name Isaac?
Don't know if it's weirder that you're being hunted by multiple agents, or that you know them all personally.
Oh no. Mako, you've gotta help me, please.
If you're gonna tell me SIS is after you, I already figured that out.
Cardery's just one of the agents after me. Isaac's the one leading them. If he finds me...
What? What's he want you for?
I've gotta go. I've been on this channel too long already. He's on Drummond Cost looking for me right now. If there's anything you can do to stop him.
Wait, Coral, what's going on? Why is he after you?
They're already trying to trace my location. I have to go, please. You're the only hope I've got.
What is it with people never answering my questions?
Gotta be hiding something.
Oh, that was weird, wasn't it? It wasn't just me, right? She's really like me, isn't she? I really have a sister. Let's go to Drummond Cos.
Okay, so long as you know that's gonna bite you in the butt, believe me, it will. It will. That was awfully suspicious. She's like, no, I would love to answer your question, but I'm not going to. You're like, okay, it's pretty weird.
Meet our new product. Had our salt shipment bottled as special tablets to help organics retain water. Now we just need to seal the deal. I want you with me when our prospective buyer calls. Keep him from getting too comfortable.
We'll be meeting an Arcona named Gruna to convince him to act as our supplier to the colony.
Sounds simple enough.
This chump would do anything for enough credits to get off Tatooine. I don't think it'll take much to get poor Gruna to bite. Gruna, good to hear from you. Looking well. Lose some weight?
Well, I, hello again, Master Rowing, and,
Oh, her? Ah, don't worry about her. Had to let my last security detail go in favor of this fine lady. Say hello, my dear.
We look forward to doing business with you, Gruna.
See? A perfect lady. You know, Gruna, I'm a bit of a philanthropist. Did I mention that?
No, I...
My visit to Tatooine left me inspired by the plight of rugged folks like yourself trying to squeeze life out of that dust bowl. Making life easier for the little guy, that's my motto. And helping you hardworking souls is now my personal mission.
He'll put himself in the poorhouse if that's what it takes.
My associate worries too much. My friend Gruna and his pals wouldn't leave me holding the bag. There'll be plenty of prosperity to go round. The top chemists at Rowing Industries developed this little wonder for us. A compound designed to maximize water retention in organic life forms. The benefit to hardworking subsistence farmers such as yourself is immeasurable.
It's really impressive, Master Rowing, but I don't know if we can afford something that fancy. Most of us are barely making enough to keep food on the table. We're just trying to save up the credits for passage home.
Can you be sure you'll ever be able to afford that at the rate you're going? We're helping you use less water, leaving you more to sell. It'll pay for itself several times over.
You're in a good position, Gruna. You stand to make a lot of money as my distributor once things take off. Tell you what, I'll send you a sample. If your friends aren't begging you for more in a matter of days, you can keep it. No charge.
I'll do anything to turn things around here, Master Rowing. I appreciate the opportunity you're giving us.
Don't mention it. I hope we'll be hearing from you soon. Come on, partner. I have a feeling we'll need to increase our supply. Now we wait for Gruna, gets his friends hooked, and watch the credits trickle in.
I have to hand it to you. You were right.
Of course I was right. I didn't get to be the infamous Tiresias Loci by placing sucker bets. You seem to have a knack for this line of work. I think it's time we take off the kid gloves and find a big score. I'll do a little legwork while you find ways to spend your newfound wealth.
Ugh, man, I just really don't like him at all. And it's pretty lame to rob these poor people, so that's pretty lame. Boss ship, really big and fancy. Not like Slam Salvage Tug, but Slam not have anything fun like shields and huge space blaster. Blizz not be bored for a long time.
Guess you really lucked out by signing up with me.
Blizz like that new boss have lots of new things to show Blizz. Blizz already learned everything to know about salvaging. Blizz going to miss old crew, especially Slam. Blizz wonder if old man can be okay without Blizz.
Now that they've left the White Maw, they shouldn't have anything to worry about.
Boss probably right. Blizz think boss needs Blizz more than old crew. Blizz not disappoint. Okay, there we go. Well, I guess we will head to Droman Kos first. Do the side mission, and then we will hit the main one. Alright, here we are on Droman Kos. We're gonna try to help out Mako, but I don't trust that coral chick for a second. I feel like she's definitely gonna use us, so we're gonna keep my eyes open.
Hold it right there, Coral.
For the love of... I'm not Coral.
Don't do anything stupid. We should wait for Isaac. Are you crazy? What are we supposed to do? Ask her to just behave herself? I'm just saying Isaac will be here soon. Let's not jump the gun.
Hello? Guys, can we talk for a minute?
Maybe Isaac will get here soon, or maybe he'll decide to stop for lunch first. We don't exactly have a lot of options here.
Don't turn your back on someone with a blaster, ladies.
Yeah. Hey, over here! See us? Like to talk to you.
Someone is gonna answer me this time.
Hey, girls! Over here! Look out! She's attacking!
Well, that's it. No one ignores me. Nobody. idiots. Both of you. Alright. Back to the ship. Alrighty. Let's see what Mako's thoughts on that were. It's like way too many Makos running around.
Sorry, did you say something? I'm sort of half here. Not feeling so good. I keep seeing those dead girls. My sisters. I just feel queasy. Anyway, sorry. Did you need something?
You don't look so good.
I'm fine. Just really weirded out. Don't think that's a medical condition. I don't exactly know how to get over seeing myself. The two of me die. And you know the worst part? Coral didn't tell me. Didn't say a word about other sisters.
Coral has some explaining to do.
No kidding. I'm getting answers out of somebody if it kills me. Or them. Preferably them. Let's get moving before I get even more weirded out.
Good plan. I don't know why it's playing like the Dark Betrayal music. It wasn't that big a deal. Play something happier. Alright, anyway, heading to Nar Shaddaa.
Home again. I hope this visit's better than the last. Anyway, Bloodworthy sent directions and the passcode for the elevator. Should take us straight up to the top floor. You ready to hit the promenade in style?
Torian, you're my arm candy.
Ma'am?
Lock down the ship. We'll meet at the party.
Just me? Come on, that'll take forever.
I'll help.
Torian, I want you along. She's got all the help she needs.
He's like, I'll help. I'm like, the heck you will! You'll be with me, bro. Like I said, you're my arm candy. It's just like Mako and Blizz and Galt, if it has to, lock up the ship. How hard could it possibly be to lock up one ship? Okay, so we are almost on the promenade. I gave away, we had one gift from the Mako mission. Torian he didn't like it, so I gave it to Blizz because it was a large influence gain for him. So there you go. Also, we have two letters that we've had for a while that I failed to notice. So first one is from Mandalore. You did well. Jakon Kadera's been dead to me a long time. Terrace was as good as a death sentence, but somehow I knew he was still out there. He'd always been too stubborn to die. Honestly, never thought I'd see him again. Hard to believe he's actually gone. 10 years ago, I wouldn't have thought twice about putting a knife in his heart. Now I remember the good old days. Wonder if he'd have felt the same before he crossed blades for the last time. Before we crossed blades for the last time. No sense in dwelling on it. I understand Stracolan's boy is with you now. Take care of him. He's got a legacy to carry on. Oh, I will. Don't worry about that. And then we have one from the corporation. Our sincerest apologies. It has come to my attention that you were troubled by an incident that occurred during your recent visit to our Quest Refinement facility. While Adaska Biomechanical cannot be held responsible for the circumstances surrounding the incident, we do apologize that your visit was disrupted and would like to extend this complimentary gift to make up for your visit during being cut short. We hope that you still continue to consider Adaska Biomechanical for your future adrenal and pharmaceutical needs. Sincerely, Director of Galactic Relations Corporation, Citizens, Adaska, unleash your potential. Alright. So basically they're like, hey, sorry we tried to kill you. Here's a, here, this'll make it better, right? I'm like, the heck it will! Aw, man. Torian doesn't like that food. Hey, Blizz, far. Do you like this food? Yes, he does! There you go. That's for you, buddy. Hey. It's too bad that I'm... In some ways, it's too bad that I'm romancing Dorian. Or Torian, not Dorian. That I'm romancing Torian. Because if I wasn't, and if I didn't have anyone to carry, I would absolutely carry Blizz. He's way too adorable to not carry. Anyway, alright. Now we will head to our objective. Welcome to the Star Cluster Casino. It's been a while since we've been here. I've never been on... I've obviously been on the top floor for this mission, but... We haven't been on the top floor, I don't think. But here we are now. You guys ready for a party? I certainly am. Come on, Torian. We have a party to attend with my good bounty hunter friends. The best in the galaxy, as it were. Alright. Come on, dude. Uh-oh. That's not good. Thank you.
I'm sorry. They refused to cooperate. No sign of the fugitive.
No matter. Advance the timeline. Adeline, call in support. Vendus was certain you could be reasoned with. I was mistaken to indulge her. This is your last opportunity to surrender peacefully. Don't be as foolish as your friends here.
You just made this personal, Jedi.
You're all so eager to die. Adeline.
Take her down!
Oh, that's it. You're all dead, you hear me? They were my friends, we were gonna have a party! And how's that the Jedi way? They attacked me! Like, that's just, oh my gosh. Like, they attacked me, all they had to do was leave us alone. We were gonna have a party. Which, in some ways, I guess that makes me the best bounty hunter in the galaxy. I mean, you know, in some ways. Because now, all the other good ones are now dead. And this Jedi is gonna die. I will kill you, I will kill everyone you've ever known, I'll kill your parents, I'll kill your kids, you're dead! You hear me, Mr. Jedi Man? You're dead!
I'm coming for you, understand? You're dead.
This isn't over. There will be no more even-handed offers, only swift, definitive retribution.
I'll find you. I always do.
You'll try.
What about them?
We pay our respects with a hole in that Jedi's head.
Skira, I can get behind that.
Mako, get everyone back to the ship. We're leaving.
I just finished getting ready.
We had party crashers, Mako. It's a bloodbath.
You're kidding. You're not kidding. Okay, I'm on it.
Oh, that's it. He's dead. You'll try. Oh my gosh, I'm going to enjoy killing him for sure. Well, back on board the ship. Guess we'll hear what the plan is now that all of my buddies are dead.
Hey, come here quick.
The attack claimed the lives of a delegation of Jedi and Republic officials on Nar Shaddaa. The apprehension of the individual responsible for these continued acts of aggression is our top priority. Senators, I assure you, the orchestrators of these attacks will be made to account for them.
Why did the Supreme Chancellor of the Republic just give an address about you?
Delegation, my eye. This is a frame-up.
There's gotta be more to this. I think frame-up is selling it short. The Republic just placed you at the top of its most wanted list. The list of charges is a kilometer long. Massacring an entire terrorist resettlement colony. Hijacking shuttles of refugees and selling them into slavery. Assassinating the Senator of Ithor. Sabotage resulting in the destruction of the ecosystem of... It just keeps going. Half of the stuff we didn't even do.
If they think I'll let them pin all this on me, they've got another thing coming.
I don't think they plan to let you dispute the charges. They're offering a 10 million credit bounty for your capture.
Mom would be proud.
Congratulations, that's more than every price on my head combined.
Better get off Nar Shaddaa.
Kid's right, every 2-credit hood on this moon is gonna be gunning for us.
Before you plot a destination, it gets worse. Accusations are flying all over the holonet, and Imperial officials are making a big show of burning any bridges between us. I don't know what the Empire's idea of full cooperation is, but laying low in Imperial space is looking a lot less likely.
My hit list is getting so long, I don't know where to start.
Let's just get out of here, we can plan the rampage later. Actually, we might not get to plan it at all. Take a look at this. It's an Imperial summons. We're to rendezvous with an Imperial fleet in the Outer Rim to discuss our recent activities.
Discussion? Yeah, I bet.
It doesn't sound like a request.
Doesn't matter how they phrase it. The fact is, if they're like, if we didn't want to go, we just don't go. It's not like they know where I am. Just saying. They can't, they could demand all they want. If I just don't show up, then what? Riddle me that, Mako. Well, that's it. They're dead. All of them. Everyone is dead. You hear me? Everybody. But before that, Torian.
Got a good crew.
It's gotten a lot better since you got here.
No complaints. Haven't been part of a company since Ariadu. Missed it, I guess.
Can't think why you'd miss that.
Got its points. Gotta have someone watching your six. Wonder what Clan Ordo's doing now.
Glad he didn't take offense at that, because that's not quite how I meant it. It sounds more like,
I don't know why you'd miss it.
I'd be like, well, of course you'd miss it. The camaraderie, the brotherhood, and or sisterhood. Just saying. All right. Travel to the Tyrant. Guess we'll rendezvous with him. I mean, who knows? Maybe it's a good thing. Maybe they're not all gonna kill me. I mean, they're all gonna... Maybe they're not gonna try to kill me. Let's put it that way.
We're coming out of hyperspace. Everyone up front.
There's the fleet. I hope you're right about this.
I look on the bright side. They open fire, and we'll be breaking the galactic record for going from zero to space dust.
Battle stations?
Warm up the turrets. Keep the targeting computers on standby.
Charging to full. Blizz, shields.
Leia Starling and Bulldog.
Hail the flagship.
You know this is probably a trap. Even if they don't shoot us down, handing us over to the Republic would probably help deflect the flak they've been getting.
I doubt the Empire is interested in doing the Republic any favors.
I guess, but they're putting up appearances for some reason. Better not take any chances. Hailing, they're transmitting a flight path. We're to dock in Hangar 8.
They aren't shooting at us. So far, so good.
Well, we're committed now.
No fear. No fear. Yeah, I mean, there's no way these guys are like, oh yeah, we'll totally help out, Republic. Like, they hate them. Like, even if they're going for some political maneuvering, it doesn't matter because their real intent isn't going to be to sell us short. Know what I mean, Jellybean? Okay. Put down the lizard for luck. Are you with us, lizard, Torian? All right. Let's hit it. No fear.
I'll feel that later.
Ah. My team ready for battle. All right, you guys stand there and remember to keep calm. Torian, you come with me. Hi.
My presence was requested.
I've been ordered to bring you before my lord, Darth Tormund. Submit to search and seizure and come quietly.
I don't really care for that plan.
You are under jurisdiction of this Imperial vessel, and I will not permit you to remain armed in the presence of a Lord of the Sith. You will comply, willingly or by force.
Anyone still around by the time the lieutenant here hits the ground joins him.
Seize this scum! Cowards! You'll all be court-martialed! What are you waiting for?
Morons.
I'm not scared of you.
Who do you think you are, huh? I'm the most dangerous bounty hunter in the galaxy, remember? That's such a good line, though. It's just like, anyone who's still here by the time the lieutenant hits the ground, joins him. That's such a good line. Let me just top off me health. Move this little coin and punch this dude in the face.
You won't get away with this.
Quite a pile we stacked up.
So, do we make a run for it?
I came here to speak with the Sith. That's what I'm going to do.
I don't have a better suggestion. Let's do it.
Mako, lock out access to this hangar and be ready for further instructions.
No sweat. We're all counting on you.
Alright, well, it could have been worse. Alright. You with me, Torian? So that didn't go, you know, that's not the best negotiation I've ever had, but at the same time, it's probably not the worst one. It's like, man, I showed up here, this is a freaking warship, like, You have lots of guards, okay? And he's a Darth. Like, it's just... like, how much threat, I mean, you know, from a lore perspective, how much threat could I possibly be? You know, if this Lord of the Sith can't handle one bounty hunter with a gun, then he deserves to be shot. And I'm not gonna feel bad about shooting my way to the deck either. Alright. Take a look at the map. Okay. Just around the corner. Kind of a waste, though, that all these guys have to die. Still, though, it's no skin off my nose. I'm not scared of you either, droid. They can't stop us, buddy. The body count is just gonna rise every time they try.
I see you've disposed of your escort.
Can't say I appreciate Sith hospitality.
Start. Destroy what is mine again, and I shall return the favor.
Gonna remember that.
Today, Corellia's leadership swore allegiance to the Sith Empire. Despite total occupation, the people openly rebel. What should have been a bloodless victory has escalated into full-scale war. The Treaty of Coruscant is no more. I want the Supreme Chancellor's head in my hand when I deliver victory to the Dark Council. You will provide it.
That doesn't sound like an offer.
You will be adequately compensated. If wealth and acclaim are not enough incentive, perhaps revenge will motivate you. You have made an enemy in the Supreme Chancellor's closest advisor. Do what I ask and you will have your opportunity for vengeance.
The sooner I get to break that Jedi's face, the better.
So long as our enemies remain on Coruscant, they are beyond even your reach. But Jun Saras will not be difficult to draw out. Getting to him will put you within striking distance of the Supreme Chancellor. Corellia is where we will put them down. There are obstacles that must be removed before we can act. You will remove them.
Person, place, or thing?
Some old enemies from the last war have re-emerged. A Republic privateer made famous assisting Hilo Vis break the Mandalorian's blockade. And a Kuati noblewoman credited with orchestrating numerous successful uprisings on Imperial-occupied worlds.
Consider them dealt with.
This star chart shows the last destination of your first target. Make it his final. My subordinates will brief you upon arrival.
Mako, the situation's taken care of. Unlock the hangar. I'll explain when I get back.
Really? That's it? Okay, see you soon.
What can I say? I speak Sith language, man. Violence. That's the language of the Sith. I speak it pretty well. Yes, I may have burned my way to his, you know, to the Darth, but the fact is, he got all aggressive on me first, okay? Just like, and if helping him gets us to the Chancellor and that Jedi, I will happily help him. It's like, deal. I could care less about the money, bro. I am in it for the revenge I'm gonna get. I'm gonna kill the Jedi, I'm gonna kill the advisor, I'm gonna kill all the people he's known, I'm gonna kill everyone close to the Chancellor, and then I'm gonna kill him too. And I'm not even gonna feel bad about it. Lols. Alright, we can get to the ship, and we can turn it in, and yeah, that'll probably be a great place to stop. I'm pretty sure we might be in Chapter 3 now, I think. It is possible. Maybe. We're either in Chapter 3, and I think we are. Because I think the turning point of Chapter 3 is when your friends die right there, and then you get all of this bounty on your head. I think that is where it turns to Chapter 3, so... Which is cool. Chapter 3 is a lot of fun in this story.
Mako, run this data.
Alright, just one sec. Okay, I've updated our astrogation computer. This is a pretty obscure system. Thanks, Blizz. I think I've got it. Last I'd heard, Belsavis wasn't even worth colonizing. The Imperials have it designated as a Republic prison world, though.
We'll find out more when we see it ourselves.
I'll keep an ear to the ground, just in case.
Alrighty. There we go. Lots to talk to. We might as well talk to Mako, because we're right here.
What is it they say about curiosity again? Does it involve lavish paid vacations? Maybe Trandoshani flatcakes? So, I may have gone back into the SIS computers. Just a little.
SIS probably won't mind at all, then. Seem like real understanding guys.
Sure. I mean, what could go wrong? Remember how I said I found birth certificates from my family? A dozen of them? Well, I found out that 10 of them also have death certificates.
Sounds like SIS is doing some cleanup.
Cleanup? Like they were all...
Okay, sorry, didn't realize that what that sounded like. Let's try that again.
What is it they say about cubes? I guess
that means there's nobody wondering why you don't call.
You know, I'd even planned my excuse for missing holidays, too. I guess it's just me and Coral now. Well, on that cheery note, let's move on, huh?
There you go. 18 influence with her. That's pretty aggressive. B. Aggressive. Torian wants to talk! You think it freaks him out when he watches me leap over the side of that... of the walkway? He's like, holy crap!
That friend I said you reminded me of? Got a holo call from him. Turns out Cordan heard about us taking down G-Cone on Terrace. Sent me an invitation.
He didn't draw a line in the sand, I hope.
Over G-Cone? No. He'd have done the same as us. Said he's hunting big game. Offered to let me in on it. Plan to take him up on that. Wanted to let you know. Won't be long.
Not going to introduce me to this friend of yours?
Don't like competition. Corydan would spend the trip trying to impress with you along. I want you to meet him. Got catching up to do first. Catch you later.
How was it?
Amazing. Met Corydan and half my unit on Duxon. Good hunting. Bomas and Marvers mostly. Jagger bagged a Zock egg. Lucky Jare.
Did my big hunter skin us a fireside rug?
Tried. Marvers aren't known for their hide. Just their mange. Got a few more stories to tell. Can't ask for much else. Back to hunting prey on two legs. Right?
That's right. Oh man, and he's not even opposed when I start flirting with him. That's a great sign. We're getting far, kids. He's breaking. I'm wearing him down, to quote Family Matters.
Notice anything different?
You should lay off the junk food.
And they said this stuff was slimming. Just acquired some nice form-fitting blast armor. Thought I'd see if it would stand up to a trained eye. Apparently so, if your observation is any indication.
Glad that worked out for you.
Since I'm still putting myself in harm's way, I decided to make a little investment in my well-being. Been stocking up on interesting tidbits at every port we've hit. From here on, I'm ready for anything.
Well, there you go. And little Blizz. Hey, buddy. Boss, Blizz have a question about Boss's job. Blizz pretty sure that Boss not a pirate, but Boss does beat up lots of people. Blizz confused about what Boss does.
Some people don't appreciate my work. When they get in my way, they get hurt. I'm a bounty hunter. I track down individuals nobody else can find.
So Boss find people, it's in hard to reach places. Blizz think Boss sound more like a salvager than pirate. That okay with Blizz. Blizz like being salvager better anyway.
Glad we're on the same page. Mostly.
Sometimes space things confuse Blizz, but Blizz smart, figure out lots eventually. Biz's old crew helps Blizz understand many space things. Blizz still miss salvaging with old crew. Blizz think about them lots. Blizz probably never sees Slam or friends again, all because of stupid Dreely Tomb.
I thought Aeor was responsible for you getting chased off.
Three-eyed droid man, old white ma boss. Dreely tell droid man Blizz stealing. Dreely and Blizz not really get along. Dreely always pushing Blizz around and taking things because of Dreely bigger. Not anymore, though, not with boss around. Oh, I missed the last thing he said because I hit space right as it switched. Sad face. Actually, wait, we can have a chance. There we go. Blizz ready to help, to keep helping boss. Boss ready too. There we go. We saw it. Shout out to the chat. Thank you, Tubi. Okay, I don't think we have any gifts. So, I'm thinking we're going to make a wee little switcheroo. Not that. I'm thinking it might be time to go helmet for a while. But while we're there, that's not the only thing we're going to do. We're going to hop over to here, and we're going to go to Companions. And Torian. Torian. And I think we're going to turn on his helmet too, I think. Well, we'll have to wait until we're on the planet, but I'm probably going to move his helmet so that his helmet shows up for him, too. I think that would be pretty sweet, man. But yeah, I think we might go helmet for a while. Anyway, so off camera, I have to hit all these heroics. Sad face. However, we are almost level 42, so that'll help a lot. And I do believe we are in Chapter 3. I think Chapter 3 starts with Bell Savis. This was all the turning point, so that is fantastic. We made crazy time. I can't tell if it is either one of two things. I can't tell if A, we are just getting really good at this and we are very efficient with doing our missions and cutting and stuff like that. I can't tell if that's it, or B, if the Bounty Hunter story is just shorter than the other ones. I really don't know, but it feels like we barely started this story and we're already almost 42 and we're in Chapter 3 already, so that's fantastic. I feel like we made record time with this one, so that's very, very fun. Off camera, of course, like I said, I will level. It wouldn't surprise me if by the end of this week, if we were done with this story, just because even so far we've been doing two stories per episode, two planets worth per episode. So obviously we have Bell Savis, we will have Voss, and then Corellia with little trips in between. Now, unlike what I've done with the last few class stories where I push really hard in the last episode where we're finishing it today, is what I say, and then it ends up being a 5-hour episode. Okay, I'm trying to avoid that this time. This time, we're gonna just play it cool, play it chill, we're not gonna push, we'll play as normally as we always do, and then we will see where it lands. I do think it'll be shorter than most other episodes, though. It'll probably end up being, I don't know, 8, 9, or 10 episodes, so it should end up being right in the middle, but it just feels faster than the other ones did. Anywho, so that is going to call for this one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the content today, and we will talk to you guys later.
Hey guys, it is Darth Bowinkle here.
You want to know what I know? Two wrongs don't make a right, but three rights make a left. That's what I know. Oh man, I can use the Force. I'm a Jedi, Mom. You like landed on my face, and not in a fun way. No, I'm kidding.
The drawbridge is the least of our concerns at this particular moment.
Oh wow, they actually are violent. What a nice change of scenery. It's easier to do something about the flat guns when I'm not being chased by every German fighter in freaking Germany! Something large has my number, and he's calling me for a date. I'm not interested. Aw. Thanks, creepy computer mom. Andronicus, you're in my dream too. Let's be honest though, you're always in my dreams. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the content today, and we will talk to you guys later.